India, and this time he's a politician. He's playing in a different pitch. He's none other than Kirti Azad. We have with us in his own constituency. He's campaigning. Sir, ye bataiye ki how is the pitch here?
I think Mamata Didi has made it perfect, and BJP is going to be hit for a six. I mean, the way she has worked, the way she has various yojanas for the people, and when you talk about Modi, he hasn't presented his report card in the last 10 years. The problem of unemployment still there. 15 lakhs never came into the accounts. Rising prices. Mustard oil, which was 30 rupees in 70 years, in 10 years it's become 160. There's so many other examples. And people are really very happy with Didi. And you can see the kind of reception that they're giving.
Question which comes, which the opposition is telling about you, that you are an outsider, and they have themselves won. Trinamool has been saying that BJP is an outsider. How do you take this?
I played for my country. I'm a property of the country. I won the World Cup for the country. That World Cup is the property of the country. And whenever I played at Eden, I got the same love that I got anywhere else in the world. And if that's a question that is being asked to me, I would want to know. I played for my country. And the entire nation loved me. Mr. Narendra Modi was only a chief minister, yet also a tainted chief minister of Gujarat. How did he come to Varanasi? So if the BJP is able to answer that, I definitely will answer this question, which I have already answered the question. Secondly, what about Mr. Dilip Ghosh, the Abhadra Manush? Bengal is known for the Bhadra people. It's known for its culture, its tradition, and history. And here you have Mr. Dilip Ghosh, the kind of language that he uses. I have never seen anybody in Bengal doing that, because I have found them all very soft-spoken and nice, not from now, but from the time I have been playing cricket.
But he's also an heavyweight, you know, a former state BJP president who brought in 18 seats for BJP. So how do you sue? Do you think that it's a tough fight?
I don't think so. I think Didi, there are so many Gauravas, they'll be coming here. She's a Mahishasur Mardhini. I mean, last time they said that Abki Baar 200 par, and they couldn't get 200. And the surprising part is, a party which is not even contesting 400 seats says 400 par, which is very laughable. So I feel that they have nothing to show. Modi or Amit Shah, none of them have said anything as to what the central government has done, except for when they come to Bengal, they abuse Bengal. Then they go to Bihar, they abuse Bihar. But they don't show that report card. Didi doesn't have to show the report card. It is there on the ground. People get it from birth till death.
Jai Maa Kali. Didi ko malum hai ki agar chhota hota hai bachcha to maa ko tab se hi man mein chinta hota hai.
There has been also charges against your party of corruption. You know, a lot of corruption issues, recruitment scam is there, ration scam is there. When you are going to the people, don't you think that this is becoming somewhat embarrassing? And that's what the weapon the opposition is picking up.
Nobody is talking about it. TMC has never stopped anybody from investigating whatever have come out. But has anybody been so far indicted? Has anybody been so far been accused? Is the big question. Now, I ask you a question. What about all the corrupt, which Mr. Modi was shouting from rooftops when he was shouting from his meetings regarding Hemant Biswa Sarma, regarding Suvendu Adhikari, regarding Ajit Pawar, regarding Narayan Rane? How they get washed into the washing machine? Will the BJP answer that? BJP has given more than 100 seats to people who are not from the BJP but from the outside. So will they answer? Why are they giving it to Ashok Chavan, whom they said that he was the one who took away the flats of the widows? Or the martyrs? So, I mean, will he come up with that answer? The question is that nobody is asking this. Everybody would come and ask what Mamata Didi has done. But nobody will ask what Modi has done for the last 10 years. After all, he should show us this report card. Except for trying to divide people on religious lines, what else they have done? He's back onto it. After having lost the first two phases, he's back onto his old tricks. I mean, apart from doing Hindu-Musliman, BJP has nothing to show.
here the it was a 2800, that's what the margin was last time of how Ahluwalia
2300
yeah. So do you and people are saying ki ladai is hadda haddi, which means kaante ka takkar hai. How do you see this?
Well, last time the left had joined, the Vam had joined the Ram. This time the left is fighting on its own.
And you're sure on that the left is fighting?
It's fighting on their own. We can see. I keep on getting news from the bottom. Another thing is that in these few years, after having woken from the sleep, the people realize that BJP is good for nothing. So hence they got those two in 2019. I mean 2011 they again lost very badly. Didi gained 5 extra seats in the assembly elections. Why? Because she did what she meant. I mean, Didi said that she is going to increase the Lakshmi Bhandar from 500 to 1000 and 1000 to 1200. She said in 100 days, but she did in 70 days. Here we have Modi in 3,650 days in these 10 years. He hasn't done anything.
At the same time, when you're saying Lokhir Bhandar, that's a big weapon for Trinamool Congress, obviously, you know, 500 to 1000 and getting it to all the women voters. Women voters are 50% of the electorate. How do you see Sandesh Khali in this, which the opposition is really going gaga with that?
Well, let them go gaga. Has anybody been accused so far? The question is that if it wasn't for the West Bengal police, the NIA couldn't have catch hold of Sandesh Khali. We couldn't catch hold of him because the BJP had gone and said that he should not be arrested, and they used it in the press. Once it was opened that yes, you can go and arrest him, he was arrested within 48 hours. So, you know, it's basic perception they're trying to make. It's very laughable when you hear Amit Shah. He turns around and he says ki Mamata Banerjee ghuspetiya ghusari hai Bengal se. Arre bhai, central government ke force hai BSF, jo Bengal ka aur West Bengal ka aur Bangladesh ka border dekhta hai. How can she do it? It is Amit Shah who is doing it, just for political gain. So, I mean, it's ridiculous when he talks like this. I thought he had little sense, but he is senseless. He's got less sense than even the senseless guru of his.
What are the issues you are raising here in Bardhaman, Durgapur? It's a, you know, it's 44 degree today and a lot of other, I mean, heat is obviously an issue always here. Yeah. What are the things you are picking up?
Well, everybody knows the central government owes money to West Bengal, 1,60,000 crore rupees to West Bengal the last year of all the income tax, GST, direct tax, income, indirect tax.
But they are saying usme bhi corruption hai.
Tum paisa doge nahi aur kahoge corruption hai. I mean, see, this is the mentality I'm talking to you about. See, BJP makes a perception. You haven't given the money. Did you give the money for 7,200 rupees to the Manrega workers, which has to be given 100% by the BJP? Have they given it? Didi said, I'll give it. I won't let the poor die of hunger. So she gave it for that. He talked about the Awas Yojana, the roof. 2022 tak sabko sar pe chhat milega. Aur 2047 mein chala gaya. Kitne log zinda honge dekhne ke liye. So, you know, this is all lies peddled. And until unless you people show it, people won't know.
So, you are confident that you are going
I'll win by over 1 lakh votes.
1 lakh?
Yeah, 1 lakh ke upar se votes se jeete.
Jai Bangla!
That means you are confident that you are going to 1 lakh. And Dilip Ghosh is also confident that he is going to, you know, he is saying you are not seen anywhere.
See, the thing is that unfortunately, those with eyes want to be blind, I can't help them. I leave for my work at 7 o'clock in the morning, and in the, say, around 11:30, 12, I'm with the people, sitting with them, doing meetings, take rest, don't want them to be out in the heat at around 3:30, 4.
So, Bardhaman, Durgapur Cup will go to Trinamool?
Hold on. You talked about Dilip Ghosh. Dilip Ghosh is a character who said that Durga Maa ke maa-baap ka nahi maalum hai. ना दुर्गा माँ प्रकट हुई थी, अवतार लिया था. जो लोग अवतार लेते हैं उनका माँ बाप नहीं होता है. ये दिलीप घोष को नहीं मालूम है. दिलीप घोष सेठ की ममता का बाप कौन है, किसको ही बताए. इज दिस द वे टू टॉक? ही सेठ की बंगाल के लोगों का सुअर का चर्बी चढ़ गया. ही सेज जो लक्ष्मी भंडार लेता है वो दरिद्र है. इज दिस द काइंड ऑफ लैंग्वेज दैट अ पर्सन एवरीबडी डजंट अप्रिशिएट. नोबडी इज अप्रिशिएटिंग इट. सो दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ लैंग्वेज ही इज यूजिंग. ही वाई वॉज ही शिफ्टेड फ्रॉम मेदिनीपुर टू Bardhaman Durgapur? He was a sitting MP. We had a sitting MP in Ahluwalia. Ahluwalia yahan ka alu posh to khake gaya. Asansol chala gaya. He was a sitting MP. Why has he been shifted from here? द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट हैज डन नो वर्क. केंद्र सरकार, मोदी का सरकार कोई काम नहीं किया.
सो यू थिंक दैट द बर्धमान दुर्गापुर कप लाइक द वर्ल्ड कप विल आल्सो गो टू
सी लेट्स बी अ लिटिल मोर सीरियस. दिस इज नॉट अ गेम ऑफ क्रिकेट. दिस इज हार्डकोर पॉलिटिक्स वेयर वी आर फेसिंग पीपल.
खेला होबे इज आल्सो योर स्लोगन.
यस खेला होबे. यस
खेला होबे.
डेफिनेटली खेला होबे. So Khela Hobe doesn't mean it's going to be a game of cricket that we're going to play on a ground. Khela Hobe will Hobe on a political field. So we'll show them. Champion Mamata Didi hai, Modi jo hai wo zero hai, aur hamari Didi wo hero hai.
Azad, who clearly said that champion is Mamata Banerjee, and with Mamata Banerjee's flag, he is going to really bring the Bardhaman Durgapur Cup to TMC.